Welcome to this week's Eco Geek, powered 100% by sustainable energy.
There are over 500 million meter cube of hydrogen produced every year in the world, using about 19% of that from reformation. Unfortunately, reformation is very dangerous for the world because it produces a lot of CO2 emissions. It is heavy, I would say, and I use it again, heavy in CO2 emissions. So one way of solving this is to produce hydrogen from renewables.
So Ross, can you tell us about how you're generating energy here?
Two wind turbines that are behind us here provide the primary energy source for our energy system with our 2.6 kilowatt Proven Energy wind turbines.
Ross, can you tell us a little bit about what this electrolyser here behind us is doing?
The electrolyser you see behind us here is converting, when it's switched on, it converts the energy from the wind turbines over there. Any spare energy we have from them, it converts that into hydrogen gas, which we store in cylinders around the corner here.
As I expect you can see, it's a little bit cramped in here, and we're just going to give this car a little bit of a road test. So that quiet hum that you can hear in the background is in fact the fuel cell. Can you tell us a little bit about the fuel cell, please, Russ?
Yeah, the fuel cell power unit behind you here converts the chemical energy stored in the hydrogen gas, which we produce from the wind turbines you maybe see in the background, and it provides electrical power to drive the motor.
Okay, and what sort of fuel cell is that, Ross?
Fuel cell that's in this car at the moment is a Ballard Nexa fuel cell.
Marvellous, and can you tell me what type of fuel cell that is?
The technology type is proton exchange membrane, or PEM, and it's the type that's been most commonly adapted for use in automotive applications.
Okay, marvellous. Put your foot down, Ross.
Thank you.